Hi everyone, welcome to AMO Procedures YouTube channel. My name is AMO, and in today's video we are going to learn about web scrapping and how you can get started with it. Without wasting time, let's get started. I'm going to use a Reuters.com website to scrape some trending news, and we make our news API from the data we are going to get from it. But before we get started, what is web scrapping? Web scrapping simply means the extraction of data from a website. This information is collected and then exported into a format that is more useful. Another question might be, is web scraping legal? The answer is yes. Web scraping is completely legal if you scrape data publicly available on the internet. But wait a second, some kinds of data are protected by international regulations. So be careful scraping personal data, intellectual property, or confidential data, because I don't want to see you behind the bars. Before we continue, smash that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell such that you don't miss my upcoming programming videos. I'm going to use Python programming language and FastAPI framework at my backend. Create a Python project and install the listed packages. Create the FastAPI instance and add endpoints on it. One for get topics and another one for getting the real headlines with the necessary metadata. At this stage, Uvicorn server is going to come into place to run our FastAPI application. After this, let's make sure that packages are installed and test our API to check if it's working or not. Yes, it is working. Let's go ahead and create the scrape.py file for handling our web scrapping logic. Create two variables URL and time zone in the first place. Define a method called pages with an argument of page, which is going to return a dictionary. Using the requests library, we shall make our first request to the Reuters.com website with the page. Argument which has been passed, you visit the website. The pages include world, sports, business, legal among many others. After the request has been successful, we shall parse the result content to our soup method and parse the HTML formatter. So, we have our HTML ready to be manipulated. After let get all buttons with an attribute date a test ID equals to text button. Now let's import and call the pages method inside our FastAPI endpoint. So if we hit our API endpoint for the first time, all the buttons from the HTML response are returned as a Python list. Since we have the list of buttons or card objects, let's make a Python for loop and iterate through them as we look for the important data inside. Here when we observe, each button is having an attribute called data ID. Let's use this to split half to elements, first one being the page itself and the one being category. When we test, we get a key error indicating that one of our buttons does not have that data ID attribute. Let's go further to check each button if it has a data ID attribute. Successful. We have no error this time, and if we check the console, we find the printed page and category. Let's go further and populate our return dictionary with this data. I am adding description and query key into our dictionary. After that, I will append row dictionary to the data list object. Successful. Now our page's endpoint is working. So let me do a simple transformation to our result set, and we have the dictionary that returns the total number of items, page, and the items list. Successful, our page's endpoint is now fully functioning. By now, if we try accessing other pages like sports page and markets page, we should be good to go. If you are enjoying this video, please click that subscribe button to support my work and So now here, let's define a method called feeds, which will take the page and category as the parameters, and it is going to return a dictionary. After that, let's import it and call it in our news endpoint and later pass the page and category arguments as well. Let's hit back to our code. Let's make our request to our site when we have added page and category in our URL path. And let's obtain our HTML like we did previously in our pages method. When we open the Reuters site with world and Africa past in the URL path, you will have something like this. Our aim here is to extract the news from this page and when you right-click and click inspection. In our Python code, we will need to extract all the divs with attribute date attest ID equals to media story card. So let's make a Python for loop and iterate through the card list. Let me try to sample and find the image tag and access the source attribute only if the image has been found in the card and later append it to the data list object. After that, we shall populate the dictionary as our result. And when we test our news endpoint, we see that image key is working fine. Our next objective is to obtain the heading of our feed. In this example, we shall get all the H3 tags having data test ID attribute of heading. If we find that H3 object is not null, then we will extract the text from it. Since our H3 tag had a tag in it, we shall obtain the href attribute and get the link of that specific feed and later test our endpoint to see if everything is working fine. After getting the feed link, let's try to look for the category under which the feed falls into. We have defined the ID in our dictionary, and if we look closely on the Reuters site, we find that every list item has an attribute called ID, and in this scenario, we shall take advantage of it. After that, we shall look for other metadata, such as time, and we shall format it to point to hour. If you are contented up to this point, please skip this part. If this video was helpful, please click that subscribe button to show support to this channel. Don't forget to like and comment. Thank you.